my Quran in the semi. They say Lincoln free the slaves, so they put him on a penny. Put the Mossberg to his back. If them planes hit Harlem, would we be in Iraq?
My mom used to read us poems when we were little. That was kind of like my first introduction to poetry. Poetry and hip-hop, you know, are cousins, you know, first cousins. So in my 20s, late 20s, started, you know, doing more hip-hop. It's definitely has an influential power to it. And it's all about how you choose to use it, and I choose to use mine for da'wah. I mean, I have my biggest following is Muslim. So, you know, you got some people who choose to listen to their scholars and choose to stick to their minhaj or whatever, however it suits them. But, you know, Allah judges us by intentions and the heart. And to me, I don't feel not one iota of guilt or hesitation when I'm performing and when I'm doing this, because I know, like, in America, I live in the hood. This is something that is my tool. You know, it's not literary, it's not books, it's not what's catching the youth. It's hip hop. And I can't sit there and let Lil Wayne or anybody else influence my nieces or my nephews, you know? Or the Muslims who like listening to hip hop. It's a lot of Muslims who listen to hip hop. I listen to Brother Ali now or somebody else who brings the same powerful beats and message and same undertone, but yet giving you a positive message. Well, I did an album with Grand Theft Auto 4, and it was pretty big, you know, so I did a video game song, and it was big, but the message wasn't really where I wanted it to be, you know what I mean? And it kind of bothered me a little bit. It seems like when you're a positive artist, they want to take you away from that. Like, they want to make you do something else. And I kind of fell into that for a second. That wasn't the direction I wanted to go. And at the peak of, you know, someone's career, you kind of see what's real and what's not. And alhamdulillah, Allah blessed me to see that it wasn't real. It was all fake. So I kind of like just walked away from it. You tend to have a lot of yes men in this industry. People who just want to be around you because like you're starting to get, you know, known, and they don't care like what you do. They just happy that they're like around. No one's telling you the truth. No one's, you know, telling you, brother, you should do this, and you're going all day and you can go weeks and not make salat, and no one will stop you and be like, hey, you make salat, are you gonna go to Juma? You know, because it's all about fame, money. You have to keep people around you and keep the reminders around you. Reminders who are gonna tell you, listen, make salat, don't do this, try to stay away from that, this kind of thing.
I got questions though, who gonna answer me? Yo, who bought crack to the U.S. and you just expect us to act like we're clueless?
You listen to the radio now, how come people talking about exploiting women is not controversial? How come that's norm? How come men glorifying selling dope and selling drugs and killing people? How come that's not considered controversial? How come men talking about not raising their kids, and just how come that's not controversial? So the powers that be or the system that we're in seems to put the ignorance on a pedestal and make any type of knowledge like seem crazy. They make the person who tries to drop wisdom seem like, oh, he's a lunatic. Support is everything. Like, you have to support people that are working for you, the listener. You know, we have to support these artists and try to keep a positive movement alive. One day my kids won't have to hear all this negative nonsense. One day my daughter won't have to hear men glorifying sexual women as an object. You know, this is something, you know, that I want to leave behind. Some sadaqah to the people of positive messages where people can hear it and feel like they're not lame or they're not corny or this is what's up, you know, to do something positive instead of negative. Inshallah, more dawah and more progress. Fi sabilillah.
Quadir Lateef. Got my Ummah, and I'm with them, representing for Western New York Muslims. Bah!